Hi, my name is Stefan Plogmann from the Accenture Innovation Hub in Essen. Today I would like to talk about project management and how to consolidate data from different project elements into one overall schedule. What I would like to show you today is Focus HQ, or our Accenture calls it the Capital Projects Control Tower. So that we are building a layer above your project that consolidates data, risks, issues, the schedule, status of deliverables, all of this into one overall view that can be shared across the entire project. But before I go there, I would like to briefly explain what kind of setup, or let's say the surrounding that we are talking about here when this such a software is used. This is meant for very big projects. So for example, construction of a new production plant, factory, or a very large building, or a long linear project like a new street or so on, which usually involves a very high number of different companies being on that project. They all work in parallel, they all use their own tools, they have their own schedules. And consolidating all of this into one overall view, identifying the interdependencies between these different groups and if delays affecting the other people and what are the so-called interfaces, which is not a technical interface, it's the interface between project deliverables, how they are all interlinking. And that is usually a very, very big effort that involves a lot of manual work. And we want to show you very briefly now, as a first teaser a little bit, how you can make that much easier with a very simple user interface, web-based. Let us start with the dashboard view, which is a very general overview. Who's the project manager? When did the project start? What's the budget? And so on. Please bear with me, this is all dummy data, it's not fully filled. I don't want to really show you the project details, it's just about the concept and what are the different elements here that you want to consolidate and how to work with it. So you see here the main milestones, and you can split that into multiple layers. So you can have probably multiple sub-projects, for example, building A, building B, building C, then another project managing the utilities between the different buildings and so on. So you can build all of these different layers. You can assign different roles to it, who is responsible for updating it, and then you consolidate it up into an overall project level or program level. And then what you can also do is, in this system here, you can also consolidate it to a portfolio level. So what's, for all my 20 or 30 projects I'm running, what's the current status? And you can consolidate all of them in one view. It starts with a schedule, which basically says when something is going to happen, the main milestones, and so on. Anybody then who has a respective access rights can then directly, for example, say on every of these steps here that I want to make this a project milestone, a portfolio milestone. So from an activity, they're saying this is an important milestone that I want to report to the upper layers. By just clicking on it, I can also make this as mark this as a deliverable, which is also really helpful. So for example, in a project, you often assign deliverables part of the contract to certain stakeholders. So for example, engineering company A is supposed to give you the design for something. Then you can say, okay, that activity of doing that takes that and that number of days, yeah? And then you can also click here by having one click, you also associate this with a deliverable, which is really nice because then the deliverable tracking and the activity tracking is not two separate things. It's combined to each other. And of course, I can also edit them. The details here can say who's the successor, what are the due dates, what are the resources that I need to assign, and so on. Also very important is that you have a consolidated action tracking, saying then, for example, I have identified a problem, I just want to say, okay, do that. I assign a ticket basically to someone, please do that. I can track this as an action item here, write down a few sentences, whatever they need to do. And what I can also do is I can also create this out of meeting minutes. So I can say, this is a meeting, in that meeting we decided something, and then I directly associated to that meeting, I can assign then the respective actions. Same with risks. Risks can be created. It's basically a ticket, yeah? But I can raise the risk. I can rate it, how important it is, what the potential impact of the risk is, and I have a large number of different templates for that. That I can say, for example, this problem. For example, I don't have some information ready available now, or potentially not coming. So this might have an impact on my planning accuracy. It already predefines the descriptions to make it easier for the people to just enter this stuff. Yeah. Same with issues. Issues are basically the same like a risk, but it's something that has materialized. So it's not anymore a risk. It's now an issue because it really happened. You can also define a budget here. So it's a very basic budget tracking, which you can also link theoretically with SAP. Yeah. And you can see then the total expenditure to date compared to what you originally planned, and this can be updated. Either by taking the data from an ERP system like SAP, for example, or by simply manually adding it. What's really nice about this platform that we use here with Accenture is that I can, for anything here, I can define really basic CSV file uploads. Probably it sounds primitive, but honestly, it's the reality. So, because if we can agree on one thing, it's a spreadsheet. So, the people can just download the sample data, can look at it, and then they can pre-fill based on that sample data the information, just upload it. That's really basic. Of course, if you have a partner where you work a lot with and there's lots of data being transferred, you could link it directly with their source systems. For example, their ERP system, or when it comes to the schedule, I would, for example, link it with Oracle Primavera or Microsoft Project. I can install a plugin, press a button, bam, it uploads the information into the central repository. So all of this aggregation is really what's the key thing. And making it simple is good. Simple is good here because big construction projects have many variables. Everything is changing all the time. So I don't want to create a pseudo accuracy, a pseudo detail level, which is far beyond what the actual reality is. And and the last thing is, of course, documents. You can define in the beginning, this is really primitive here in that example, but you can define deliverables. Okay, I need, for example, a planning document ready by that date. I can link it with my schedule. I can assign it to the people, and I can also assign budgets to it. So this is then also something that I can use to consolidate the tracking from the different groups. And that allows also to basically integrate data from, for very small companies, probably two or three people. They don't need a lot of IT. They can simply also go into here and enter it directly, and thus reducing the effort for the PMO team, project management team, to consolidate and manage all of this to have the overall view. And that is, for us, a very important thing to improve the efficiency and quality of any big project, so that you, at least on the project scheduling interdependency side, that you are more integrated and have a better visibility here. Other elements are then, of course, document exchange and so on. That was a very quick excursion into that topic. Hope you're interested. If you would like to find out more, please subscribe to our channel, contact us, and we will hopefully soon also provide another video where we go a bit more in detail and not just a teaser here.